let's continue.
I heard what you said, but I think you should say it, because I'm not sure I'm on with it. You should say what you think the concern is.
I don't know if this is a concern. I wanted to talk to the mayor, Napolitano, and I went to the site today to access, you know, contact us, and, you know, I couldn't get through to the contact information. I kept getting error notices and all. So I just wanted clarity on the site.
Sure.
And also talk to the mayor, and so that we can formally back, you know, 300%.
Could I talk about this? Because it's very important to know that.
Yeah, because I'll let you talk in a sec. Let me share with everybody else to have a discussion. Mike?
Yeah, I don't see any reason why we just couldn't have a, when we discuss it next meeting, have a proclamation done up. We could review and have more discussion on it, find out more information, and then if it's appropriate, we could pass it then, rather than taking it to another one and have another proclamation.
Yeah, I'm comfortable with that, too.
That's what I'm asking. Rather just table it and not put together proclamation. I agree we should put the proclamation together so we can either approve it or not at the next meeting.
Yeah, I didn't mean it any other way than that.
Okay. Go ahead.
Okay. One of the reasons why the website right now is not accessible is that when all the initiative started on January 5th, we were only kind of limiting November, and actually when the proclamation was done was October 14th, and I went back to the city of Newport and asked for October 14th to actually be the remembrance day for victims of domestic violence. Mm-hmm. I am an advocate and an activist and also a survivor, so for me it's very important for this initiative to move forward.
I understand.
However, when this started on January 5th, when we start reaching out to the other communities, we build the website only with the five first proclamations that we had. Mm-hmm. Like I said, we have 22 now, and mm-hmm. the reason why the website is not up is because we are waiting for March 8th, that is the International Day for Women, to put it up again with all the copies of the proclamations from every town. So there is a gallery, and it's the names of all the town members that have signed the proclamation. So people can access it, yes. read it, and understand who is united on the proclamation.
Okay.
It is, I know that proclamation is, it might be for a lot of people just a piece of paper, but.
No, I don't think we believe that.
I know, but for the communities, it's so important to have that acknowledgement from the local government. Mm-hmm. And you represent the people in your community. So when I went back to Mayor Napolitano, I asked, will the city of Newport support this initiative 100%? And can I use the name of Mayor Napolitano as a full supporter? And she said yes. Mm-hmm. So all correspondence that you have received, she has been CC on it.
Yes.
So she knows every time that it's going in, every follow-up notice that we have been sending. And it is more than just me going for an initiative. We are reaching out to colleges to call for it, mm-hmm. so we can have community involvement.
I understand.
And just we want to fix these social issues, you know? And that just comes through awareness.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So at this point, we have on the floor a motion to continue the discussion of this. Then is it proper to withdraw the second and then amend the motion to continue it with a drafted proclamation?
Oh, okay. I so move that we move this to the next agenda with the proclamation prepared.
And do I have a second on that?
I'll second that.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Next we have Lint Energy, continued from February 1st, 2010. Continued discussion on the cost analysis and location. We received a cost analysis and a couple more recommendations from the Wind Energy Committee. I'm not going to open up the floor. We had discussion from the public on this last week. I'm going to hold on to presenting the formal recommendation. I will direct any council member now, if they have any questions on the cost estimates in here, to direct them to directed to Don as chair of the committee, and you can answer it or have any of your members answer the question. Okay. I don't know. Yes. Did anybody have any questions about the cost estimates?
This? It just came out.
Seconds.
Just, it is still warm.
it looks like they, all the financial.
Well, I think that may be the economist's report.
Okay. All right.
I wanted to start out by just pointing out that the questions that came up at the last meeting regarding the relationship between the net profit calculations shown in the tables and the town's electric bill, I believe has been answered satisfactorily. There is no relationship anywhere in here to our electric bill, to our phone bill, or to our oil bill. It's just a generator of electricity. We get paid for the electricity. So, and the calculation is shown in here on the second to last page in the material. It shows we have electricity generated times the wholesale electric price, plus electricity generated times the rent price, plus whatever IRA grant, whatever our IDC grant was, whatever those project courses, that's our net profit. So it's a straight, simple calculation. I think it answered the question about it in certainty in the calculation. It was on last time.
Yeah.
The electric bill is not included.
So basically what it is, it's a revenue generator.
Source of revenue.
Source of revenue. And not in, without consideration of any electrical usage anywhere on the app at this point.
That's great.
It'll just be into the general fund or wherever the money is. Mike, do you have any comments, questions on this?
No, so I don't know.
Do you want to come back to you?
Yeah.
All right, Bill, we'll come back to you. Bill?
I'm just looking for the other new charts here. Well, I just wanted to make sure if we made some assumptions to how much we're going to be getting in grant funds and how much we're going to be getting funded at a low interest rate. With that said, that's how our formula was derived. And at the end of the year, how much we get. So if those numbers change, i.e. we get less of a grant, then of course the money we bond for then goes up. The profitability goes down. So that's one concern that everyone needs to be cognizant of. We don't know the end result yet until we find out about funding. With that also said, it has to be clear that whatever, if we do move forward with a wind turbine project, that it is going to have to go to the voters of the town of Jamestown to vote for the funds, because ultimately they're going to be responsible. If there's a shortfall for whatever reason, the taxpayers are going to have to make it up, because they're going to still have to make the payment. If you borrow money, you have to pay it back. If we fall on projections for whatever reason, the townspeople will be responsible. With that said, I think I understand the numbers. I just don't understand the final numbers yet, which I guess we're going to have to get to the bonds for money. So I guess we have to apply for the grants and see what, if anything, we get. Because if we get zero, then $750,000 has to get bonded for.
Right. Mike, can you in? Is that it, Bill?
Yeah, I think I'm in now. So, but basically, if we apply for the grants for one, two, whatever, for the wind turbines, and we basically, if we decide tonight that we should apply for grants for two turbines, and the money that we have counted on, low interest loans, or whatever, but the grants that we're applying for, does not come through, we're not obligated. I mean, we can say we want to have two turbines, and we want to actually, what I would craft my motion to say would be that we want to apply for the grants to tentatively install two turbines, or however many. And then if we don't get the grants, we don't have to do that. We're not locked into that. Because we're not going to, I mean, obviously, if we don't get grants and the bonds are outrageous, we're not going to put it up in front of the voters anyway. Outrageous, right? We're not locking ourselves in. We're locking ourselves into trying to get money to see if we can better off the turbine. Okay. I had, let's see.